And then the last thing is, I think it's called georeferenced the image. And what that means is that if we really zoomed in here and looked at our pixels, I think what we would see, let's see, is it gonna let me zoom in much further? Do they look like they're kind of leaning a little bit? It's pretty close, but I don't think this line, see how there's like a little squig right there? These pixels are not orthogonal in that they're tweaked a little bit. Do you guys agree with that? In the sense that this guy is not going straight up, it's leaning a little bit. This whole pixel is kind of is leaning a little bit. So the last step that we do right now, this map is being georeferenced kind of on the fly, where Arc is just using memory, is basically just showing where this map is in the real world based on our control points. And what we'd like to do is create a new image, and it's not called georeferenced, it's just called rectify. So let me just rectify that situation. And what this is going to do is, when we use it, if I say rectify, it's going to create a new image using a resampling method that is saved in our geo database with this spatial reference system. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to first navigate to where I want to save this guy, which is going to be in my W7 tutorial in here. And you want to make sure that you just click the geo database. I'm going to add that. And then you may, I'm going to increase the cell size to 100. I'm going to decrease the cell size and make it 100 rather than 400, because that's going to make the image a little bit crisper. And then in order to do that, I'm going to need to resample. And even though this looks like it's categorical data, because we're dealing with ISIS and the Kurds and the government and those types of kinds of things, those names for things, I'm actually going to sample this with bilinear. And that's going to make, I think, a smoother image that results. The reason being is that we're not taking this data kind of hopefully just bear with me. And if this really bothers you that I'm using bilinear when I've made a big deal out of always using nearest neighbor for nominal data, part of the reason is that we're not going to be using this image in a raster. We're going to be digitizing on top of it. And this is just to help it's to help us as people kind of perceive the information. So I'm going to use bilinear and 100 and say, did I give it a name? Here's the name. And I'm going to call this my kind of Syria georeferenced, right? And say save. And it's going to have to think about this a little while, because I'm asking it to do a fair amount of work. So maybe I'll just hit pause here. Sorry. Okay, I think it finished for me. Let's go ahead and in here, if I throw this now on, and I can turn this guy off a little bit. And so what I now have, if I zoom into this guy, is an image. And if you zoom in now, if I turn it on over it, so what you see is I've increased the resolution, so that's the thing that we scanned, and that's the thing that we created. And by using bilinear, we just gave it this kind of smoother appearance, because in reality, this is kind of a continuous field of pixel values going from kind of mustard to black to yellow, and this gets rid of some of the artifacts that would have resulted if we'd used nearest neighbor. See how fine that is in the grade. And so anyway, but what you should see is, as we zoom in on this guy, the cells here are now, I think, going to be lining more straight up, and they don't appear as tilted. And maybe that's not the best example, but basically these lines should be now more orthogonal, and that was the result of doing the rectification. Okay, but what's nice now is we have this image that when we go to the properties has these rows, this cell size, and this spatial reference system. And if we compare that to this guy, it has this rows, that cell size, and it doesn't know. Oh, it does know where it is in the world. Oh, that's interesting. Sorry. It shouldn't know, but I guess it does now that we've georeferenced it. Well, that's funny. So now if I remove this, and let's see if it's going to prove me wrong again, and then go back over and grab that guy and bring him on. Now it doesn't know where it is. Now it's going to be back in the Atlantic Ocean. And if I look at this guy, here we have something that the extent is zero. So this should help you answer that question I ended the last video with. Why did this map get placed in the ocean? It has no spatial reference system, and it thinks that it's coordinates go from 0 to 10.6 and 0 to 6.9, right? So 0, 0 is essentially the bottom left coordinate, and where do you think 0, 0 is in the world? Okay, so that's georeferencing. Oh, damn, I went over.